with the introduction to oscillator that I gave you in the last class, which I will not repeat, and that what I told you about Van der Pol and all, the last class is more for intellectual information, what happened in the past, how the history has developed in the, but don't worry about it as far the examination is concerned, okay? Because that's a bit too high bro for you, but I just want to introduce you to the way actual oscillator analysis has to be done strictly. We will do very simple-minded analysis of the oscillators in the following class, and we take linear models for the active devices, and we must keep in mind that the linear models are strictly not valid because the stability of the amplitude will arise only because of the nonlinearities that are finally coming into picture. But at the starting point of the oscillation, we can assume that the model to be a linear model. So we start talking about what is the condition for oscillation, assuming linear models, okay? And by this analysis, we are not going to get what is the amplitude you are going to get out of the sine wave, but at the moment, we are not interested in that. So what we would do is, again, go back to my feedback network. In the feedback analysis, we put a minus sign here, and we talked about the error being this minus this. Just for oscillator, not necessary to do, but it becomes easier to see. Let's put a plus here. Okay. So then the same arguments hold good that the this is V0. Then V in plus B right. These are the two equations you will get. Then V in by V naught by V in from this expression, previously we got a plus here. It becomes minus because of the sign change here. When this becomes 0, then this becomes infinity, which implies that we get an output even for a 0 input. So which means for if that condition is met, then I don't need this. And this can directly go in here. That is why the plus sign is put there. So now this system will give output even without an input, provided the condition of A beta is equal to 1 is met. With me? So this condition A beta is equal to 1 for oscillation condition is given by name discovered by Barkhausen and this is normally called a Barkhausen condition. But what it just simply says is the loop gain must be equal to 1. So now the choice for you is to take an appropriate A of S and appropriate beta S such that this product of this is equal to 1 at the frequency of your interest where you want this circuit to oscillate. If at that frequency this is satisfied, and there is oscillator at that frequency. Okay? One of them has to be an active device, or this, for the reason that if you don't have some activity in the loop, then the wave you will get will be a decaying sine wave. So to keep that amplitude almost constant, you need to have some amount of power that is to be put into the system so that you go on increasing the, keeping the amplitude constant. So that, this is a passive network generally, and this is an active network. That's why I'm called using the symbol S, meaning the way is an amplifier, which has the ability to give higher output power compared to input power. But it's not which you call A, which you call B in this context is irrelevant because it's a loop. So you can put A here and B there and so on and so forth. But A is usually the amplifier which has a power gain, and beta is a passive network which has no power gain. So the you can make you can think about infinite number of oscillators which will give you various which will give you output of a sine wave correspond to choice of AS and beta S. So classically, if this beta S network is a consist of only resistors and capacitors, then the oscillator arising out of that is what is known as the RC oscillators. This contains only resistors, capacitors. It will have some transfer function. And the transfer function, as you know, will have poles in the negative real axis on the S plane. And that will give result to the going through this loop here. It will shift towards the J omega axis and make those poles oscillate. If beta S consists of resistors, inductors and capacitors, such oscillators are normally called LC oscillators. The choice is infinite choice, right? You can choose any RC network. As long as you satisfy that condition, you will be able to see that network oscillates. However, the common RC oscillators or Wien bridge oscillator and other one is called the phase shift oscillator. And you can think about many other oscillators in between, twin T bridge oscillator, all kinds of oscillators are possible. But these are the most popular oscillators among the RC oscillators. Similarly, in LC oscillators, you can think about empty number of oscillators, but there are oscillators called Kolpit oscillator. We'll study each one of these in this class. And then we have Hartley oscillator. And then you have Clapp oscillator. Then you have Pierce oscillator. There are names associated with the person who invented the circuit, so goes under these names. Then you can think about umpteen number of other possibilities. So in this class, we will study these six oscillators, the structures which are the most commonly used structure. Among this RC oscillator, the first one was the Wien-Bridge oscillator, which I don't know whether I told you in the last class or not, was invented by Hewlett-Packard, and they marketed this oscillator, very simple oscillator. You yourself will very easily see, make this oscillator, think about this oscillator. But Hewlett-Packard apparently made a huge amount of money at that time by selling these oscillators and built up this Hewlett-Packard company, what it is today.